You see the tree shaking at the back there, might be that baby giraffe feeding off the tree there. I'm trying to go around and see if we can be able to see what is shaking the tree there. It must be the same family that we've been seeing around Gowrie Dam quarantine for the last week or so. She's hiding herself behind the bushes. I'm just going to just drive around there. So we might be able to see them from the other side.
Okay.
Oh, there's a baby.
Uh-huh.
That I was talking about, yeah. I can see four giraffes for now. Might be more. The baby giraffes are so cute, yeah?
They are very.
Yeah. There's another youngster walking from right to the left, so it might pop out in the gap there where the female was. See if we can sneak in through this gap here. Don't run away.
Oh, shame. I've got to go.
This is an old road, eh? That big bull giraffe is hiding himself behind the bushes at the moment. So it's definitely the same guy that we saw down in the dip there, just off between dams, on our way to the elephants. But we don't normally go off-road for giraffes. But because they've been pretty scarce for a very long time, and the people have been wondering where the giraffes were, and we have to go off and take a good look at them. Unbelievable, yeah. It's another breeding herd of elephant down at Gowrie Dam. How many are there, Jared? Wow. Jared reckons about 20 elephants. It's amazing. Here's a big boar. George of the jungle. If I'm not mistaken, George was 6.2 meters tall. It was the tallest giraffe in the world. So 6.2 is 18 feet, you're right? 6.2 meters. Yeah. That was George. Of the jungle. Apparently it was in Asia, I can't remember exactly where. Anyone can still remember, please let me know. Very elegant creatures, the giraffes. There we go. Looking at us. Okay, there. Please wait for me, Mom. Don't leave without me. It's very strange because giraffes aren't vocal. Eh? So if the mother wants to move on and the baby doesn't want to follow, or the mother's feeding 50 meters, there's George. 50 meters apart, and there's a danger coming through, and the mother wouldn't be able to give the baby a shout, just to be aware of the danger. I've seen female giraffes trying to rescue their babies from the lions, and they also got killed by lions. Gage is moved off as well. Now I can turn the wolves.
What? No, really?
Yeah, not much. Yeah. They are at the giraffes. No, negative. It's still fine for now. See if we can move it around the other side. So the feeding off the large acacia tree that has been pushed down by elephants fairly recently. So I'm driving to the sun now. It shouldn't be. Hello, Eugene and Jereen of the jungle. Okay, folks, just to let you know again, this is 100% live in the Juma Game Reserve, Sabi Sands. And Catherine is behind the camera on the jigger this afternoon, Gerard in final control, and I am driving you around in this beautiful afternoon. I'm still with these giraffes here. There's two babies here. There's this youngest baby, and there's a bigger one. I'm just wondering if the big one is not the first baby of this female giraffe, and this is the second calf. We're gonna giraffes. Don't give birth to twins. It's one baby at a time. And obviously when these babies and then they vary in size and ages. They have a very, very beautiful eyelashes to giraffes, huh? Very, very cute. Look at the markings on the body. Yeah, Ez was talking about the lions killing baby giraffes and the mothers. And the giraffes defend themselves by kicking. They can kick back and forth just like a zebra or a donkey or a horse. And sometimes a giraffe can kick a lion to death. But there have been lions that have been kicked to death by giraffes or broke the jaws from the giraffe kicks. Yeah, I got. Hello, Anne. Anne wants to know if giraffes are ruminant. Yeah, of course they are, and the giraffes have four chamber stomachs, so they process their food 100%. And sometimes you see the giraffes standing absolutely still, ruminating, or even lying down sometimes, especially after dark when the temperature is nice and cool. I've seen giraffes lying down and ruminating. Most of the antler species are ruminant. Feed off the leaves from many different trees. They release a tannin, and the tannin makes the tree or the leaves taste bitter. You might have seen a giraffe or any browser feeding off the specific tree, and it will literally stop feeding and move on to the next tree, because what has happened during the process, and then the tree has released that or pushed out that tannin into the leaves just to make itself taste bitter, and the giraffe will move off, or whatever animal is feeding off it. That's how the protect himself from being overgrazed. It's just amazing how the nature balances itself. And at the same time, the brushes help the trees. To prune the trees. So nature is absolutely amazing. And sometimes you can be able to tell what animal has been feeding on the different trees, just by looking at different levels, how the tree has been pruned by different browsers. So one day, if I see the tree that has been browsed in the different levels of it, and I'll stop and point it out to you, so that you can have an idea if there's been a kudu or a nyala or a giraffe being feeding on it.
just going to quickly have a look at the colours of the sunset, Pat. There's not much in terms of sunset, but...
Absolutely stunning afternoon.
Try this rather. Here we go.
Just to let you know again that we live from Juma Game Reserve in the Sabi Sands. So what you're seeing here is happening in real time, yeah? It's getting cold now. I'm gonna put my jacket on. So guys, if you've got any questions, you can send them through to Final Control at safari.tv. And Gerard is in Final Control this afternoon. Catherine behind the camera, and I am presenting this afternoon. So we don't stop the crew during the course of the drought. So the same people do the drought. I'm just looking at the elephant coming through there. No, that's a giraffe. Wow. Okay, thanks. So the same crew stay for 3 hours. Oh wow, my word. This is unbelievable. I can't believe this. It's another head of elephant down at Gari Dam. Again. I don't know how many elephants are in the Western Gari alone this afternoon. And I'm not gonna estimate, because I don't want to lie to you. But if I will have to guess, I will say that the must have been about 1/4 fright
for some reason.
What do you say, Gerard? Because you've been directing this afternoon. I've been seeing all these elephants coming down to Gari Dam. So there was a head of about 20, and it was about the head of about 30 elephants. There was other head of about, but the head that I saw after drive this morning down the Garu Dam was probably about 40 plus. Wow, and I believe that, yeah. And Jared reckons that there could have been about 150 elephants that came down to Garu Dam during the course of the day. But how about the other elephants that didn't come to Garu Dam? But they are, well, they've been in the Western Gari during the course of the day that we don't know of. We're looking at around 200 plus. It's a question for me at the same time. Hello, Anne. Anne's just saying that other than the Maasai giraffes, what other giraffe species do we get? I don't know where she's talking about. Anne, if you're asking about the giraffe species in the area where we are, we only have this particular one. The southern giraffe, and now there's also reticulum giraffes and the other species of giraffes. I'm not too sure about the other African countries which other giraffe species they have. Okay, Jared just saying that from Final Control that there is about 12 different species of giraffe in the world. That's very interesting. I didn't know that either, that there's a 12. Different types of giraffe across the world. I was thinking less than that. If I was writing an exam and they asked me how many giraffe species we get in the world, I would have written 6, 7, whatever. Anyway, she's definitely enjoying a tree. Yeah? She started from the other side at the tree, and then she's going around it now. Yaga. Oh. Look at the markings of this, of the mother giraffe. Ellen is asking about the African people. Presumably the Shangaan speaking people, if we have any superstitions, beliefs about animals. I'm just thinking of the few that I know of, Ellen. And an owl. Shangaan people are very superstitious about owls, hammercops, snakes. I'm going to go in detail on each one after I've mentioned the names. Animals, just think of the large animals. Here's an interesting one, the aardvark, or the anteater. And what else? Okay. They're saying, and if I'm just going to start with an owl. The Shangaan people believe that if an owl comes and lands at your house, it's bad luck. So bad luck can be anything. And someone in the family might get sick or die. And the same is the hammercup. It's the same thing. So if the hammercup comes to land your house, and they say what they believe about the hammercup. What the other interesting thing is that if the hammercup comes to the end of the house, and they believe that it will bring snakes at your house. Or bones from the dead people, the people who have died many, many years ago and that have been buried or something like that. Which is something, some stuff that is just very weird, you know. And the other belief about the hammercup is they say when the hammercup builds its nest, and after it has finished building its nest, and it will go and find the snakes, bring the snake to the nest, and then the snakes must stay there to look after the chicks of the hammercup, which I don't think that is true. Because the snake will obviously eat the hammercup chicks. So I don't think the hammercup will do that stupid thing. It's just what the Shangaan people believe. And what else I mentioned? I mentioned the aardvark, and the aardvark has got a very, very long nose. So if there's an aardvark at the village or somewhere, or it has been seen somewhere, because it's so very, very rare, and obviously many people would like to go and see it, and the pregnant women wouldn't be allowed to go and see the aardvark, because what they believe is that if the pregnant women see the aardvark when the baby born will have that long nose like an aardvark. I'm not sure how true that is. I'll think of the other animals that the Shangaan people are very superstitious about, Alan, and I'll let you know as we're driving along. I think there might be a little bit more, or a few more, that the Shangaan people are superstitious about. Oh, the other one is a pangolin. They're saying if you kill a pangolin, you must make sure that its blood doesn't drip onto the ground. And if the pangolin's blood touches the ground, and that means there will be no rain for 10 years. That's very bad. But it will never rain for 10 years. I've had a lot of old people talking about it around the fires. You know, the fires are the very good story telling places that. But you must just make sure. In fact, if I kill the pangolin as a young man, and I must take it home and then give it to the old people to skin it, and then they will make sure that the blood doesn't drip out and touch the ground. So you got to be very, very careful when you skin it. Yaga. Oh, wonderful. Thanks very much, Pat. And Pat is also saying that the Native Americans also believe the same thing about an owl. That if it comes to your house and it brings death. So I don't know. I mean, this is all these superstitions from the old generations. I know the younger generation tends to ignore lots of things, and especially when it comes to superstitions. I also told you about the steenbok the other day and the mongoose, that if you are traveling somewhere and you see the steenbok running across the road from the left to the right, that they say it's bad luck. It's not going to be a good trip. So you should rather go home and try next time. But if the steenbok runs from the right to the left, that means, okay, that's great. And you'll have a wonderful trip. So you can carry on. Same as the standard mongoose that I told you about a couple of days ago. That if it runs across the road with the tail up, that means good, okay. You can carry on, but if the tail is tracking on the ground, and that means it's not going to be a very good trip.
Straight back.
Thank you. giraffe.
A big log coming.
It's a plant here. Another female. The agar. Hi, Eric. I was also asking about the Shangaan speaking people, if they look at the stars, do they believe about the anyone's legions? Let me just think. Now that I know of Eric, and perhaps I have to find out about it. If the Shangaan people think about the animal legions when they look at the stars. Now that I can think of. That's going to be my homework, Eric. So please remind me when I'm on drive again next time, if I will have an answer for you regarding that. What I'm also going to find out is why giraffes have long necks. I knew why, but now I can't remember. It's been a long time. Beautiful.
It looks like all the vertebrae in her neck, hey Pat?
Yeah, I can
see. Knobbly.
Yeah, I can see that, yeah.
It is.
Look at that. It's definitely the vertebrae, yeah. It's just sticking out. Folks, have got any questions about the giraffes before we leave them? Just please feel free to send the questions to FileControl at wallf.tv, and my name is Patrick presenting this evening, and Catherine thanks Gerard. Sorry about it folks, it's send your comments or your question through to FileControl at safari.tv. Sometimes I still have wallf name in my head. And I'll try my best as I can to answer it for you. And Jared is still in final control. Oh, look at the baby's drinking from the mother. So now I have an answer which baby belongs to who. Other female just popped out from down in the deep here, so it must have been feeding down in the deep there, since we have been with these giraffes. So that youngster belongs to that mother. Okay, we're going to be leaving these giraffes to themselves. And they're slowly moving into the thickets now, so, and it's getting dark anyway, so we're not going to bother them that much. I hope they'll still be around Western Gari by tomorrow.